we actually start.
So I'd like to give a little explanation for about what is about to happen.
Okay. So, here's what I need you to know. So we figured Arizona's a little too warm, so we're going to bring down the temperature a little bit by playing a few public solstice. And then after that, we are going to ruin all of your holiday cheer. And hope you ruin the song deck of all for you forever, so you will never unhear what we are about to do. And do a mashup, so it'll be great. And then after that, giving the violas melodies to song.
Thank you. piece of trash.
I
I heard, I was teaching and I heard the high school group do it, and I said, someday when I'm teaching high school, I'm going to do this piece. And this is actually the second time I've had an opportunity to do it at high school, but there's a story. And Sophie was sweet enough, she said, maybe you should tell them the story. So I'm going to read the director's notes. So, I think what this piece is about. The composer, Brian Bonson, newly said, I learned an amazing lesson before I began this piece. While I consider myself to be a good person, I read a friend's comment about seeing a homeless woman named Joyce outside of Target. Joyce needed a new pair of shoes because it was getting cold outside and she only had sandals. My friend decided to get her some shoes, but also decided to buy her lunch and some extra food. During this time, my friend asked Joyce, how will you heat up the canned soup? She replied, usually the microwave at 7-Eleven works. My friend continued, why don't you get thick peanut butter? And Joyce replied, because it's too heavy for me to carry around. While the two shopped, my friend noticed that every single person around them averted their eyes as they walked by. It gave her a tremendous amount of perspective and a desire to be much more empathetic in the future. During this, I thought the same thing. Just a few hours later, I was standing outside a food store with my children, and there was a man outside asking for food. I watched quite a few people walk by him, some muttered sorry as they walked past, but most of them didn't even look at him or acknowledge him when he spoke to them. Finally, with my new perspective in hand, I walked up to the man and asked him if he was okay. All he needed was something to drink and a little bit of food. I took him into the store with me and bought him something. The man's name was Bruce. He was 32. He had three kids, two in elementary and one in middle school. He acknowledged that he had made mistakes in his life, was trying really hard to get back up on his feet, and was in the area so he could be close to his kids and be involved in their lives. We chatted for a bit before I had to run and get my youngest to stop to a soccer game. As we were leaving, he held the door open and said, thanks. It's carbon people ignore you all day long. Thank you for stopping. With the holiday season approaching, the contrast struck me hard. Most of us are already making our lists, and others are bugging us for them so they can start their shopping early. We are annoyed because we have to go to several houses on Thanksgiving Day or open gifts to several homes or travel during the holiday season. And the reality of someone like Joyce or Bruce, they want food, water, and for someone to know, acknowledge that they exist. There are many holiday pieces about everything you can imagine. This one begins with a single individual, a solo cello, just asking you to notice them while everyone walks by. Some dropping a few coins or a dollar, but avoiding conversation with them at all costs. As the music develops, we experience a wide range of emotion as the joy of the holidays is juxtaposed with solitude. Ultimately, in this particular story, the individual is joined by another, and eventually, there are four of them, the quartet at the end. As a couple people begin to leave, one speaks behind, the violin soloist, and the person who wishes them true. Please share this story with your audience. It is my hope that this piece will spread awareness and help individuals all over the world. Donate your time, donate a small amount to a charity or shelter, or smile and say hello. You may just make someone's wish come true. right now on stage and just wondering about the whispering is about, right? So far, I'm really concerned about your time. And so I'm going to save you all a little bit of time, okay? I know a lot of you have a position, you're going to the Nutcracker. So I'm going to save some time this year. I'm going to give you the Nutcracker in 3 minutes. No, look at the music. What more do you want? You only watch this from across the state anyway, right? Nobody cares. I'm just kidding. So, will you guys do me a favor? This will be the first and only time I ever ask. Can you guys tell me? It's been very interesting. I've had, what did we start at? 4 minutes and 30 seconds, 4 minutes and 20 seconds, 4 minutes and 90 seconds. So far, our record is 3:08, but we did get 2. They remember this stuff. I didn't do it. So, cross your fingers, it's 3 minutes-ish. If you want less than that, you can leave.
Thank you. Thank you.